Welcome to Farley Hall Equestrian Centre. I'm Gavin Crossley, I'm the yard manager, and on behalf of Lord and Lady Beerstead, myself and the rest of the estate team, I'd like to welcome everybody here and thank you all for coming and helping us celebrate this. It's very important for us as an equestrian centre to build relationships and build links with industry sectors, not only to promote the yard, promote the clinics and the training days that we do, but to also help our liveries and support them in their chosen disciplines.
What a joy to be here. Thank you. And just, I can't wait to get the full tour of the yard and see the stables and see the investment. But when you walk into a place like this, you really know that it's been built with horses at its heart, with riders trying to improve as the main objective. And doesn't this just make you want to go round and round in circles for hours on end? And that, as a child, was something that I was rather impatient about. I didn't like training, although when we first had a meeting with our careers teacher at school, and she said, "What do you want to be?" I said, in front of all my schoolmates, "I want to be an eventer," because I wanted to ride at the Olympics, obviously. And she got very excited because she thought I wanted to be an inventor. And when I clarified it, there was no joy at all from my careers teacher. But I rather hope that we're living in a world now where working in sport, whether it's managing events or whether it's actually competing, is considered a much more worthwhile career. And the big sort of thing that I want to push through is that equestrian sport is for everybody. That actually we can get talent from any walk of life, we can get people involved in horses, that there is a real benefit to society for having ponies and horses in our lives. And as somebody who grew up falling off on purpose, because my father had told me you had to fall off 100 times before you could be a proper jockey, I think that taught me actually not to be afraid of falling off. And therefore in life teaches you, in a way, not to be afraid of failing. And you can't be afraid of failing. You've got to recognise that the potential is there to fail, but in a sense, embrace that potential and just try to fail a little better next time. This, however, is a rip-roaring success. This is a magnificent setup, and it's going to benefit an awful lot of people, and horses and ponies. And I just look forward to seeing the smiles on people's faces as they enjoy the facilities. So it's a real honour to be asked today to do the official unveiling, which I will try not to mess up. And I now officially declare Farley Hall Equestrian open. Thank you.
We moved here in 1952. We bought the house up on the hill, Farley Hall, and we had 100 acres. Over the coming years, various farms got vacant, and we now have 1,700 acres here, all available for hacking. And we bought this facility, this site, in 65, which is part of the Swallow Hill Park. It took us 6 years to get it through planning, for various reasons. And finally we started work, and the dates were when we completed it. But we still always wanted to do an indoor facility. But also the other thing we wanted to do is, when I used to ride on a pocket point and I wanted to go down and train before work, the horse was fine, the horse was looked after beautifully, but then me trying to change in a cold lavatory at the back of the outdoor lavatory at the back of the stables before I went into work wasn't entirely successful. So one of the things we'd like to do here is make as good a facilities for the riders as we have for the horses now.